proposed amendments to Australia's citizenship laws. Before I get into the substance of these changes, I want to note my own close connection to the concept of citizenship. I'm an immigrant to this country, to this great country, one whose family has made a conscious decision to build a life, a family and a future on these shores. Like Premier Berejiklian, English was not my first language, and it was certainly not that of my parents. But my family, immediate and extended, has always cherished the opportunities Australia has provided. We are proud to tell people abroad that we are Australians, that we believe in the land of the fair go, and that Australia is the most successful multicultural country in the world. Mr. Assistant President, this measure and others our Prime Minister is embarking on are a transparent and mostly unnecessary sop to satisfy the more reactionary elements of the Liberal National Coalition parties, to say nothing of the crazies in Pauline Hanson One Nation Party. They are another demonstration of what happens when a leader is beholden to grubby backroom deals, too cowardly to stand up for what is fair and good in our politics, and too weak to provide a real policy direction or address real issues of health and education and the welfare of the people. Mr. Assistant President, instead, this policy seeks to divide us further into fields of us versus them. It pushes diverse communities out into the fringes. It fosters the kind of exclusion and demonisation of people and undermines a harmonious society. Applicants for citizenship will be asked to demonstrate that they have integrated into Australian society and undergo a more stringent English test, which will include reading, writing and listening. They have to show that they are Aussies, have integrated by joining clubs. Clubs? What clubs? Will Marconi Club or the Cypriot Club or the Macedonian Soccer Club or the Polish Club or the German Concordia Club or the Japan Club of Sydney fit the bill? What clubs is the Prime Minister talking about? Our Prime Minister says migrants will have to support Australian values. To me, he lacks all sense of values, shallow on principle or standards and on basic code of conduct. Just ask Tony Abbott. In the words of the Anastasia Polisek, who recently called him arrogant, disrespectful and worse Prime Minister than Tony Abbott, he certainly does not fit the bill to talk about values. How dare he question the values of migrants who worked hard to build this nation? How dare he insult my mum, who no fault of her own, can only say a few words of greetings in English because she had to look after a family of 11, and my father, who laboured all his life, paid his taxes to put food on the table. Migrants worked the factories and cleaned the floors and slaved their lives away from family and country, and we have a Prime Minister who, for a fistful of votes, is prepared to insult and question their values. Mr. Assistant President, I finish by focusing on the higher threshold English proficiency test being proposed by the federal government, a requirement that Carla Wilshire, the Chief Executive of the Migration Council Australia, has emphasised as being problematic. In particular, we should remember that, and I quote, vulnerable sections of the migrant community, particularly of those from refugee background, often come after prolonged periods in camps and can be illiterate in their own language, and we're bringing them here for humanitarian reasons, end quote. Those tougher integration requirements like proof of employment, school enrolment, community contribution can be difficult to implement and prove, especially given the limited resources already lacking in localised settlement services. When we keep pushing up the requirements for citizenship to this great country, I have to wonder, would immigrants like my parents, like the Premier's parents, be able to become citizens in this day and age? Mr. Assistant President, we have made great strides towards maintaining our reputation and our achievement of being the most successful multicultural nation on the planet, but if we start riding the wave of xenophobia, intolerance, populism and ethnic nationalism, as seen in France and in the UK and in Trump's USA, we will quickly undo the good work of decades and successive generations. We are and must be better than this.